Our thanks to Sarah. Back now with the panel. Jeffrey Lord, I want to start with you. Do you think the president-elect went far enough today disavowing this neo-Nazi group that spoke just a few blocks from the White House? Or do you think he should hold a news conference? Do you think he should look at a camera and say it out loud?
They're not worth the attention. They're Nazis. They're socialists, right? They're Nazis being the National Socialist Workers' Party or whatever it was called. No, don't give them the time of day. I mean, one of the things that I've been talking about identity politics for years as being racist, and this is exactly why, is that everybody gave a pass to other groups, you know, talking about their racial identity, and this was the be-all and end-all, and now suddenly up pop a group of white people. This is exactly what happens.
But
the
Jeffrey,
left sort of provoked this. This is a really disgusting thing.
The left, sorry. What did the left do here? They didn't hold the meeting at the Reagan, you know, center over the weekend. Go ahead.
The left, whether it's Black Lives Matter or La Raza, I mean, you can go back and back and back. Groups that identify themselves by race provoked this group to identify by race. This is America.
But here's the problem with your argument, Jeff.
Christine Quinn.
They're not identifying by race. This isn't a meeting of, you know, the German club or something at a high school. This is a group of individuals, Jeffrey, who stood in a room using Adolf Hitler's language of people who saluted him and said it with using Trump's name. The president-elect of the United States, he has an obligation to denounce it, not say if they're energized. Jesus Christ, how could you be more energized than that? Jeffrey, stop saying my name because I'm not stopping talking. And you know what? I have a right to identify as a part of the LGBT community. And they don't have a right to say I should be killed because I'm a member of that community. And I didn't incite anyone by being who I am and being proud of it.
Hillary Clinton was endorsed by the Communist Party. I'm still waiting for her to denounce that.
Hillary Clinton is not the president-elect of the United States.
Anna Navarro, jump in here. Anna, go ahead.
Look, here's the problem with Jeffrey's argument about identity politics and attacking identity politics. He supported a candidate who is now president-elect that has spent the last 18 months using identity politics as a wedge issue. Do you think when he calls Mexicans rapists and criminals, that's not identity politics? Do you think when he goes after Muslims and says we're going to put them in a registry, that's not identity politics? I don't know what the hell you call it, but in my book, that's identity politics. And what Donald Trump has to do is take responsibility. He has unleashed the Kraken. That's why it is not a coincidence that after he got elected, hate crime spiked up. It is not a coincidence that the KKK celebrated his victory and wanted a parade in North Carolina, or that David Duke celebrated his victory.
Oh,
it is not a coincidence that these white supremacists were holding their hands up in a Nazi
David
salute
Duke
saying, Hail Trump. It is not a coincidence. If he wants to put the Kraken back in its cage, he needs to take leadership. He needs to take ownership. He needs to know he has a responsibility in this, and he needs to go out and try to unify the country. Stop fighting with Broadway. Stop fighting with the New York Times. Fight the division in the country.
That's
fight the white supremacists. Stand up and be a unifier, for God's sake.
Anna, that's what he's done.